the equation will be ES. What is ES? The EMF induced in the secondary of the coil is minus NS into d phi by dt. So it is again the same equation what I have written there, but only difference here is there we are talking corresponding to the primary winding, and here we are going to talk corresponding to the secondary winding. Therefore, the EMF induced in the secondary winding of the coil is given by the secondary number of turns, that is NS, multiplied by the rate of change of flux. The rate of change of flux, that is very important, d phi by d. So the equation is given here for calculating the secondary induced EMF or EMF induced in the secondary winding of the transformer by this number of turns and d phi by d. Right, we have come up to this point. That means there is an EMF induced here in the second. The mutually induced EMF in the secondary coil S will circulate the current in the load circuit provided the load circuit is completed. Here, can you say that there is a load current here? Current flows? Current cannot flow here. Why? Because your coil is in open condition. That means open circuit, there will not be any current. Current is zero. So here, you need to connect some load. So when you connect some load, maybe resistive load or any other thing, naturally what happens now, since the load is connected here, there will be current that passes. That is called as secondary current. I think it is clear about this. We have given this primary voltage, it has created primary current, it has created flux which is AC in nature, and this flux which is passing through this body of the core is cutting each and every turn of the secondary winding and producing a secondary EMF. Induced EMF we call it as, basically. It is not directly, it is induced EMF. And this induced EMF will produce a current IS if the secondary winding is connected to a load. If it is not connected to a load, we cannot have current here. But of course, the secondary EMF will be existing, but current will not be there. Therefore, the secondary winding has to be connected to a load in order to see a current flow in the secondary winding. The mutually induced EMF in the secondary coil S will circulate the current in the load circuit provided the load circuit is complete. This is now the load circuit is complete. That's why you can see the current flow here in this one. Hence, energy is being transferred from a primary coil to the secondary coil by means of mutual magnetic field. I think it's clear. It's very easy. Now, here we have supplied the energy and here the energy is available. That means the transfer of electrical energy from primary to secondary has taken place, and thereby the device is known called as transformer, right? It is transferring the electrical energy from one winding or one side to the other side of the circuit, which are physically not in contact, which are not in physical contact. That means they are not connected together, but they are separated by the insulation provided. Now let us just have some idea about the types of transformers that we practically can have. Right, and how they are divided and what factors they are or what basis they are classified. Transformers are classified into three types. I just give the idea about this classification of transformer. Types of transformers. Right, so position of the windings with respect to each, with respect to the core, depending on the position of the windings with respect to the core, we classify the transformers into two types. That is, I'll write this as based on the position of winding windings with respect to core. So we can classify the transformers into two types, namely core type transformer and shell type transformer. So about the construction of these two transformers we have already studied, and we came to know that core type transformer, there will be two separate arms over which the windings are wound. That's why the position of the windings will be separate and they are on two different arms there. Whereas in case of shell type transformer, as we have saw, there the central core is bound with the two copper wires which are separated from each other, but both the windings are on the same central core, right? That's why position of the windings with respect to the core based on this particular point or based on this particular criteria, we classify them into core type transformer and shell type transformers. Now coming to the second one, that is core type and shell type. And second one is shell type. Now the second criteria based upon which we can classify the transformers into different is transformers ratio. Actually it is transformers turns ratio. Transformer turns ratio it is basically. By mistake it is written as transformers ratio. So based upon the turns ratio, what is this turns ratio? It is N1 upon N2, where N1 or NS. NP is nothing basically primary number of turns and NS is secondary number of turns. So based on this NP to NS ratio, we classify the transformers into step up transformer, and second type is step down transformer. Step up transformer, step down transformer. In case of step up transformer, the number of turns in the secondary are greater than the primary. So here in case of step up transformer, here the number of turns on the secondary is greater than the number of turns on the primary. Please remember this. Step up transformer, the number of turns on the secondary NS is greater than the number of turns in the primary. And step down transformer, it is basically opposite. The number of turns on the secondary is less than number of turns in the primary. That means on the primary side we'll have more number of turns, and on the secondary side we'll have less number of turns. That is the step down transformer. These two transformers are used very extensively in all practical purposes in electronic circuits as well as in electrical applications. So this step down transformer, as you know, that is the basic component most of the power supply circuits of your electronic circuits. See, most of the electronic equipment that we have today, either TV or computer or any other electronic gadget we have got or appliance we have got, basically in all these things the power supply circuit is basically consisting of the initial device which is called as transformer. So the use of this transformer is basically to step down the AC supply voltage to the required value according to the requirement. Plus we also can have the other advantage. What is the main advantage of the other advantage is we can have isolation from the mains. That means the main supply is isolated from the circuit of your power supply which is connected to various parts of your equipment, and therefore the isolation is one important advantage that we have got. Plus we can have the step down requirement of your application. Step down requirements, if you want 15 volts you can have, if you want 24 volts you can have, depending on the secondary winding turns that we have used in the construction part of the transformer. So step up, step down transformers both are very popularly used in most of the applications here. And another important thing is step up transformers are used in electrical circuits for stepping up the voltage for other purposes, but in electronic circuits also we use it, like in CROs, right? In CRO basically we require around 2 kilovolts approximately for the final anode of the CRT, that is cathode ray tube, and this much of voltage we will be getting it by stepping up the main supply voltage 230 volts, by using a transformer called a step up transformer. And there we have the primary voltage which is approximately around 230 volts, and secondary number of turns will be more in number, so that we can step it up approximately around to 500 volts, and this 500 volts voltage is further rectified, right? It is rectified by using a circuit called as voltage quadrupler. Quadrupler means multiplies the voltage by 4 times. So 500 multiplied by 4 will give you 2000 volts, and this is how the high voltage requirements are basically generated by using the step up transformer, right? Therefore both step up and step down transformers are used in most of the applications. The difference is that in the number of turns. So based on the number of turns, which we call it as basically transformers turns ratio. Next, third type is based on the service. Based on the service for which it is intended for. So, based on the type of service, we classify the transformers into distribution transformer and power transformer. Right? Distribution transformers are basically used for distributing the voltage from, let us say, from 33 kV to 11 kV, right? And like this. And power transformer also will be used basically for transferring the voltage from some high value to low value or low to high value according to the requirement, and that is where the power transformers will be used. Therefore, the classification is basically done on three important criteria. One is positioning of the windings with respect to the core, and second one is transformer turns ratio, and third one is type of service that we use it for. Now, so far we have studied about what a transformer basically consists of, what are the important parts of the transformer, and followed by that we have seen how a transformer basically works in transforming the energy from the primary to the secondary side. Now, after having studied about these things, how this transformer is, since it is an element, right, it's a component, basically electrical component, this must be represented by some symbol, and therefore the symbol of the transformer is being given here for your circuit analysis purpose later. Of course, we are not going to do any circuit analysis using transformer here, because we are studying basically the construction, operation and EMF equation, and analysis part, of course, it is not there in the syllabus, therefore, but you should know what is the symbol that is used for the transformer. The symbol is simple, very easy to remember. You need to have two windings, that is two coils are there, right, and on the other side. And here, of course, I am showing a number of turns to be equal, but practically either they will be more or less. That means primary number of turns and secondary number of turns will not be equal. If they are equal, we call it as 1:1 transformer. That means number of turns in the primary is same as number of turns in the secondary. So this particular transformer, when you have the same ratio, what is the advantage here? This is called as basically the isolation transformer. That means especially for TV circuits, when you want to isolate this TV circuit from the main supply voltage for servicing purpose, etc., we can use this isolation transformer, which is basically called as case 1:1 transformer. So in between we have to put two. So this will be representing the two lines, vertical lines, which are shown between the two coils will be representing the core. This is the representation of core. This is the primary winding. This is the secondary winding. So primary winding will be applied with a voltage called as primary voltage, and therefore this will be setting up what is called as induced EMF, self-induced EMF on the primary side, EP, and there will be a primary current IP on the primary side. Similarly, on the secondary side, if the secondary coil is connected to a load, this load is represented by RL, and there will be secondary current IS, and there will be induced EMF on the secondary, that is ES, and there will be voltage set up across this load, which is V2. Not V2 actually, it is VS. So you have got all the details here in the transformer. Primary voltage, primary current and induced EMF in the primary. Secondary voltage VS and secondary current IS and the induced EMF in the secondary winding of the transformer. So this is basically the symbol of the transformer, and here I have not represented the number of turns. Number of turns on this side is represented by NS, and number of turns on the secondary side is represented by, number of turns on the primary side is represented by NP, number of turns on the secondary side is represented by NS. So here N will be representing the number of turns, and V will be representing the voltage, I will be representing the current, and E will be representing the induced EMF. And of course in the diagram they are all shown very clearly, but they are designated as V1 instead of VP and E1 instead of ES and I1 in place of IP. The difference is only in the designation, otherwise the details are as I have explained. Please remember this symbol is very important. Now in case if I want to show a step down transformer and step up transformer, so how to represent this, that also I would like to give you an idea. Now I want to use a step up transformer, for example step up transformer. So how to show this? By symbolic representation. So when I want to use step up transformer, draw the number of turns on the primary, right, maybe some number of turns, and on the secondary side this is very important, this is representing the core here. So now when you look at this diagram, you find that on the primary side we have got less number of turns and on the secondary side we have got more number of turns. Therefore here the number of turns on the primary side and number of turns on the secondary side, when you look at this, is NS is greater than NP. That's why it is step up transformer. And coming to the step down transformer, so here the symbol will be this is the primary and this is the number of turns in the primary and this is representing the core. And this is NS. So when you look at this diagram, you find that the number of turns on the primary side is more and the number of turns on the secondary side is less. Therefore here what I can write, the value of NS is less than NP. Don't get confused here in representing this, particularly the number of turns. NS on the left hand side, keep it, NP on the right hand side. If NS is more than NP, that means your transformer is step up. If NS is less than NP, that means the transformer is step down. Right. This is the way to remember the symbolic representation or the symbol of transformer for step up and step down transformers. Now we have studied about the transformer construction, and followed by that we have studied about the transformer working operation or principle of operation. Now after having completed these two topics, now we can go ahead with the equation that is to be derived for a transformer, which is called as transformer equation. So this is very important for examination point of view. All the topics are very important for examination point of view. Principle of operation of transformer and construction details of transformers and transformer equation. All the three topics are very, very important for examination point of view. Therefore, we have to be very thorough with these three topics. Now coming to this transformer equation. Now let us go ahead with transformer equation, which is important for examination point of view and for solving the problems. Faraday's law states that if the flux passes through a coil of wire, a voltage will be induced in the turns of wire. This voltage is directly proportional to the rate of change of flux with respect to time. So this Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, we have already studied about this. According to this, the induced voltage or EMF induced is basically given by the negative sign of d phi by dt. D phi is basically what? Rate of change of flux, right? If we have n number of turns of wire, that means in the first case, what is the number of turns? It is only one turn or single conductor. So in case of conductor, the induced EMF is minus d phi by dt. But if you have got number of turns in the conductor, and in that case, this is given by n into d phi by dt, right? So this is the value of induced EMF in a conductor having n number of turns. Right. Now for an AC source, let, we are applying the AC voltage on the primary side, let BT is Vm into sin omega t. Let BT is equal to Vm into sin omega t. But this Vm sin omega t will be representing basically, this is like this. If this is the sinusoidal waveform, I think already we have studied about this, I think you must be knowing about this. This is the Vt, that is instantaneous value of the voltage of the AC, and this particular value is basically the maximum value of the voltage, that is called as maximum value of the sinusoidal voltage. And sin omega t is the variation of voltage with respect to this time in this fashion. And after this, this is basically called as one cycle of AC. Right? So omega is angular frequency, that is 2 pi by T. You can write. So this is basically the shape of the AC voltage. And IT will be IM into sine omega T. So when I give this VT voltage on the primary side, of course this is not a capital one, this is small V, indicating that it is basically AC parameter. And IT is also basically small letter I am using it, indicating that this is IM into sine omega T. So when VM sine omega T is provided here in the primary side, then a current IT, which is sinusoidal in nature, will be produced inside this. Since the flux is sinusoidal in the form, that is, I told you already about this, when you provide a sinusoidal voltage on the primary side, or when you increase a sinusoidal voltage on the primary side, a sinusoidal current is produced on the primary side, and this sinusoidal current which is produced in the primary side will produce a flux which is also sinusoidal in nature. That's what I told earlier also. Please remember this. Therefore, the phi t, what is this phi t? It is a flux which is produced, and which is that? This is also sinusoidal in nature. This is given by phi maximum into sine omega t. Flux also is producing a sinusoidal nature flux. That is, this is the maximum value of the flux, and this is very sinusoidal. Now, induced EMF V in the induced EMF. I will write this particular induced EMF as E induced. Right? What is this given by? Minus N into d phi by dt. Right? Minus N into d phi by dt. This was the formula, basic formula. Now, in this minus N into, what is the phi here? D by dt of phi m into sine omega t. Is it right? So in place of this phi, I am writing the value of this phi, which is phi m into sine omega t. So when you substitute this, what is that you will get? Minus n into phi m, because phi m is constant, it will come out. D by dt of sine omega t. What is the value of d by dt of sine omega t? It is cos omega t, and it will be cos omega t. Again, what is extra here? It is omega is there. Just so when you differentiate with respect to time, what is that will get? Into omega. Right? So this will become minus n omega phi m into cos omega t. This is the induced EMF. Clear about this? Any doubt in this? This is